Once again, camera shots can be used in both animation and live action film. You may already be familiar with some of the camera shots. They include, but are not specifically limited to, wide shots, long shots, medium shots, close-ups, extreme close-ups, overheads. These are all considered camera shots. Just in this section of the storyboard alone, we can see a variety of camera shots. If we start with the first panel here, what we're looking at is probably a wide shot. And this is a shot that encompasses a large area. The camera is usually quite far back, so it can take in a lot of information. And what it takes in is usually like a wide sweeping landscape or a city or something that can be used as an establishing shot so that you get a sense of where the next scene is taking place. Next, we have a close-up shot, and a close-up shot can be anything from the head and shoulders to the chin and forehead of a character. You can even go as far as having extreme close-ups where we see just the eyes of the character or just their mouth. And close-ups are generally used to convey emotion by way of showing the character's facial expression. So next we have mid-range shots, which we don't really have a good example here, but mid-range shots are usually the character being shown from their thigh upwards or their waist upwards. You just have to be careful about where you crop from, because the cropping could always look very awkward if you cut the character off right at the knees. So usually you're looking to cut the character or crop the character between joints of the body. One last shot that we have here is a long shot. So the difference between a wide shot and a long shot is that a long shot is not usually as far back as a wide shot, and what you're really looking to achieve is seeing the entire body of a character, so from head to feet. And in any good storyboard, it's always good to have a different variety of shots that are used carefully to best illustrate the story.